Hello?
Hey, Susan, this is Kim Reed.
Oh, hi, Detective. How are you? Oh, that was perfect timing. I was just getting out of Home Depot. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. How can I help you?
Okay, you were at the Republican Women of Forsyth meeting April
15th. How did I know?
I don't know how. You would never guess.
How would I ever guess? I did get a little nervous. I'm like, wait a minute, I didn't do anything. What?
No, you didn't.
Like, oh, yeah. I thought I would be getting a phone call from you.
Yes, ma'am. So you were there. What, if any, thing can you tell me about that day?
Okay. What I can tell you about that day, I did not see the simple battery occur.
Okay.
I've seen it on video. I'll be honest, I don't remember where I was positioned in the room, but I can honestly, I didn't actually see the act, other than, I mean, it's as clear as day on the videotape.
Right.
Which I'm sure you're obviously aware of.
Yeah.
Basically, again, this is pretty much, again, I'm sure you've heard this, but I understand why you're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
It was an event for, it was a Republican Women's Luncheon,
mm-hmm.
and I was one of the guest speakers.
Okay.
Nydia Tisdale had, when I got there, she was already set up, and I'm sure you're familiar with Nydia, all of the things in the county. That's what she does.
Okay.
So I had gotten there, and I was greeting some people, and Nydia told me that, you know, as far as, do you give me permission to take you? Because they're saying I can't. I said, listen, I give you 100% permission to take me.
Mm-hmm.
I said, but, you know, and I told the Republican Party that. I said, but it's not my event. So I have other things to do. I'm about to give a presentation. You know, I'm running for election, and I'm here to talk to the voters about me.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, you know, I give you 100% permission, but whatever the Republican Party does, I mean, again, I'm just going to leave that up to you guys because I got to focus on my speech.
Okay.
And then the incident obviously did happen because Nydia did. I do remember her getting her stuff together, and I do remember, again, I can't tell you verbatim, but Nydia had left. You know, Nydia had said something, you know, that I have to leave. And Peggy Green had made some comment. I can't tell you exactly what that comment was, to be quite honest, but something to the effect that, you know, telling Nydia she's not welcome here or whatever it was.
Okay.
Again, I don't know, but there was some type of comment made as far as that she had to leave.
Okay.
As Nydia walked out.
Okay. All right.
That was the gist of what happened.
Okay.
What happened. And I had conversations with Peggy Green explaining my position that I have no problem.
Mm-hmm.
You have permission to tape me. I personally don't believe that anybody can stop taping me. I'm a political candidate and I put myself out there, but I wanted to make it clear that I was fine with it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was told that, you know, it wasn't my decision. I said, well, again, you guys work it out because I have the speech to give.
Okay. All right. Perfect. Yeah, I think that was the gist of your mention and the whole thing was that you had given her permission prior to that. So I think that was the only reason why you got brought into the whole.
I'm very busy. I'm a mom, a wife, a lawyer, and a political candidate, and I'm being told that, you know, it was a public event.
Mm-hmm.
It said it was open to the public. I shared it on every Facebook I knew,
mm-hmm.
saying, hey, come see me. This is where I'll be. And I guess that's how I got involved in it. But it was a public event. It was listed as a public event, no doubt. It's no longer on the Republican Party website, but I don't know if you've seen it, but people did capture the invitation. But I can tell you 100% it was public.
Okay.
Because that's why I sent it to everyone, because it's part of the political campaign process to get to the public.
Okay.
Not a select few.
All right, perfect. Well, if you have anything come up or need me or need to talk to me or have anything, you have my number from the million messages we've sent back and forth.
Yeah, and I'm so sorry. I didn't. I'll be honest. That phone is my phone I've had for years, and I'll probably have it until I'm 80. but it died, and I can't get a new charger for it. So when I got, I don't know when you exactly left the message, but I got back to you as soon as I figured out that, ooh, I had a message.
No, no big deal. I appreciate it very much, though.
Okay.
Okay?
All right. Take care.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.